Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making poppy seed dressing. So it's a very simple recipe. But I know a lot of us just run to the grocery store and get something like this, which is Kraft brand of creamy poppy seed dressing and dip. And you can pay for that if you like, or you can put four ingredients together that most of them you would have in your kitchen, probably not the poppy seeds, but you could pick those up and you could repeatedly make this and probably save quite a bit of money in the long run. I do have a couple of recipes in Betty's Kitchen that uses the bottled poppy seed dressing, but I figured I would have more in the future, so I might as well make the poppy seed dressing and start using my own homemade dressing. The ones that are in there that you might be interested in are arugula, cherry, pecan salad, and then I have a springtime spinach salad. So if you want to take a look at those, they might have ingredients that you really enjoy putting poppy seed dressing on and would like to make your own and have a use for it. So you're going to need a small bowl. This just makes a very small amount, and you can double the recipe or quadruple it, whatever you want. If you need a lot of dressing or you plan to use it for several days, then you can put it in separate containers and have quite a bit of it. But I'm not going to need my store-bought poppy seed dressing. I'll just use this bowl, and the first thing I'm putting in is mayonnaise. So here we have 1/2 cup of mayonnaise. Just slide that in there. And then to that we're going to add some sugar. This is 2 tablespoons of sugar. Now you might think that's a lot, but this is a sweet dressing. And we're going to perk it up a little bit with another ingredient in just a minute. One thing I want to say is when you put sugar with mayonnaise or with Miracle Whip, it sort of has a chemical reaction and makes it nice and runny, and it's kind of the consistency you want for a salad dressing or a coleslaw dressing. This is the way I make my coleslaw dressing, by just putting these two together and adding vinegar, or I add lemon juice if I choose to do that. This dressing, you can see the consistency is already changing. It doesn't look too much like mayonnaise anymore. Now what I'm going to add for the zestiness of this dressing is lemon juice. This is 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. You may use freshly squeezed lemon juice. Actually, I'll tell you, I got this out of a bottle because I always keep lemon juice in the refrigerator. So it is lemon juice made from concentrate, and I think that's a very good quality, and it keeps a long time and it saves you a lot of money if you have lemons and then don't get around to using them and have to toss them and get more lemons. So just stir that around, and you see this becomes more of what you would want in terms of consistency for a dressing as you stir that. So we just have one more thing to go. It tastes good as it is, and like I said, that would make a wonderful coleslaw dressing. But I put this bottle out here just in case you weren't familiar with what it would look like in your grocery store. A lot of people don't keep poppy seed on hand unless you make this dressing or you have maybe some crescent rolls or biscuits or just some kind of bread that you like poppy seeds on the top of, then you might have this in your spices. But I wanted to show you what it looks like. You need 1 tablespoon that I've measured out here. It seems like a lot, but they're getting spread in this little sauce. And you can control the amount of poppy seeds you want to put in there. If you feel like that's too thick for you, then just cut it down to 1/2 tablespoon. I like a lot of poppy seeds in mine, so this is probably perfect for me. As I said, it does not make a whole lot, so I'm just putting it in this little cruet, which is meant for salad dressings. It will not go in very well if I try to spoon it or if I try to pour it. So I do have a funnel sitting over there that I could use, but it might be that I could just force it in this way with a spatula without messing up the top. And I'll take care of getting the rest of it after I finish this video. But I just wanted to let you see what it looks like when it is served up. So it really doesn't make that much. So if you wanted it up to here, then just double the recipe and you would have enough to do maybe four people for a salad. But probably if you wanted as much as a whole bottle that you buy at the grocery store, you might multiply it by four. And then just find a nice place where you can keep it. If you would put it in a sealed jar, perhaps something like a mayonnaise jar, that would be fine. I always save those and put them through the dishwasher and get them all clean and fresh. And then I can use them to store things that are liquidy in the refrigerator. The time that this will keep is equal to the time that your mayonnaise will keep. If you've had the mayonnaise for a while, then that cuts down on its longevity. But if it's fresh mayonnaise, then count on this staying in your refrigerator as long as the mayonnaise would. And also the lemon juice does help preserve it a little bit too. I hope you enjoy this recipe and can find a good use for it.